Hello.
Oh my.
Toys.
I didn't know what to expect.
Toys.
Oh, it's perfect.
It was nuts. It was nuts, man. So I look over to my left, and there she is. The Fairchild 670.
Are you kidding me? Can I touch it?
Yeah. He built this equipment to how he wanted it to sound. Like, the Fairchild is every single piece that was in an original Fairchild 670 down to the final resistor, but he built it himself because he wanted it to be like brand new.
I mean, every single part of that. Resistors are carbon copper resistors. So, I mean, it's like a new one built by Fairchild, you know, 8 years ago when I built it.
This facility was overwhelming. Everything inside it, he has built. Like, when I say genius, like, that's what I mean. Like, he built this equipment to how he wanted it to sound. Like, that's where his head is at.
I'm in a complete overload.
Well, I'm like you, so I can relate completely.
I'm just, like, blown
whenever I walk into a studio, away. It's like, geek out.
Yeah, I have to. I mean,
look at that name! Are you kidding me? Well, look at the one to your right. That's the Beetle machine, only that's the quarter track or quarter inch two track version of it.
Is this
Studer's C37?
There we go. So this is straight off, this is a copy to this machine off of the master tape on that machine. And this came out of a communist radio station in Slovakia. That's another great story. Can I turn this down just to tell you the story?
I want to hear the story.
Okay, so this machine comes up on eBay for $3,000, and I had wanted one for a long time. But it's in Slovakia, and he showed it as a pile of pieces on the floor. Stoughton C37 parts, complete machine but not assembled. Okay. $3,000. I thought, I don't think so. It's in Slovakia, risky. It doesn't sell. He puts it back up, drops the price in half, $1,500.
Whoa.
Now it's starting to sound interesting.
Yeah.
I passed on it again. He relisted it a week later for $800. I went, fuck it, I'm hitting the button. I emailed him first.
Yeah.
And I said, what's missing? And he said, nothing, it's a complete machine. I said, well, why aren't you selling it that way? And he goes, I don't want anybody to come back to me and say it doesn't run or this doesn't work or that doesn't work or whatever and get bad feedback on it. So I'm selling it as parts. He put it all back together for me to ship it to me.
Oh,
he built a crate for it, and I had it shipped door to door to LAX, and I went down and picked it up. That's my recording machine for this recording project that I'm doing that's all tube, because that's a tube machine.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, man. So what's the Blue Note machine?
This one. It's an A80. By the way, I've also got C37 electronics in it if you want to go tube.
If you wanna.
Yeah, that's what a record groove looks like, magnified 400 times. So you can still see, I made a reticle there, so each one of those ticks is a half a mil and the major ticks are 1 mil.
What are you looking at, like, right?
Well, there's a high frequency thing. I don't know. It could be a cymbal or a vocal S or something like that.
Okay. Oh,
I know what this was. This was I did this thing. Universal's putting out a box set on the early Allman Brothers. So it was all their Liberty recordings before they went to Warner. And so they were like another 60s band. You know, they don't sound like the Allman Brothers.
Wow.
They don't sound like a southern rock band. They sound like another pop band from the 60s.
Yeah, and, that's what this is?
Yeah.
Can we hear it?
Sure.
And this has not been released?
It was in the day, and I think they re-released it in the 80s, and this is the first time in the thousands.
You're rolling a Shure cartridge on that, too?
Mm-hmm, V15.5.
Yeah, yep.
And so then I'm staring around, I'm trying to ignore this little, like, who knows what fancy, dingy thing, like this Neumann stereo lathe from 1968 with, I learned, has a Technics SP-02 motor underneath the platter. Shout out SP series. Side note, Kevin and I have both used Technics SP15 turntables. That was a really good conversation. It's like, what are you using for broadcast? Technics SP15s. Oh my gosh, what a table. You're telling me, like, we're rocking on the same level. We're driving this whole, and so I'm walking in on this. And then I see the console. And there's Yuri Blue Strip 1176s. There's like the...